solve an initial value problem, y double prime plus x y prime plus 2 y is equal to 0, and y of 0 equals 3 y prime of 0 equals negative 2, and you are given x equals 0 is an ordinary point. So our solution is given in this form, y equals power series from 0 to infinity, c and x to the n, take the first derivative and second derivative, gives you these power series. Now we are going to plug this into this one. So let me draw a line to separate the steps here. So plug this into this one, I have power series from 2 to infinity, c n n minus 1, x to the n minus 2, plus power series from 1 to infinity, c n n x to the n. So you have x times x to the n minus 1 at the exponent together, which gives you x to the n, plus power series from 0 to infinity, 2 c n x to the n is equal to 0. Okay, now we take a look at the power. So plug in 2, I have x to the 0, plug in 1, I have x to the first, plug in 0, I have x to the 0. So x to the first is the highest exponent. That means that we have to run out terms for the order power series until we reach x to the first. So for the first one, plug in 2, we have 2c2 plus power series from 3 to infinity, cnn minus 1, x to the n minus 2. For this one, because it's already x to the first, so just rewrite it. For the next one, right now terms, plug in 0, I have 2c0 plus power series from 1 to infinity, 2cn x to the n is equal to 0. And now we are going to take a look at the index. So we have n equals 3, n equals 1, n equals 1. So we probably reindex this to 1 instead of reindex this to 3, because reindex 1 power series is easier and faster than reindex 2 power series. So reindex this to 1, I have power series from 1 to infinity, c n plus 2 n plus 2 n plus 1 x to the n, then cross this out. So I work only on this one instead of rewrite everything else again. So this is a fastest way and save times when you're dealing with power series. Now we are going to combine like terms. So look at the constant, we have 2c2 and 2c0. So 2c2 plus 2c0 plus power series from 1 to infinity. So they are multiplied by x to the n, so I factor it out and put it at the end. In parentheses, I have cn plus 2, n plus 2, n plus 1. And for this one, we have cn in common, factor it out. And in parentheses, we have n plus 2. Now we are going to equate coefficients. So let 2c2 plus 2c0 equal 0. Then solve for the biggest c, which is c2. Then I have c2 equals negative c0. Let everything inside bracket equal 0. And then solve for the biggest c, which is cn plus 2. Then we have cn plus 2 equals negative cn plus 2 over n plus 1 times n plus 2. N plus 2 on the top and the bottom cancel out. And n is starting from 1 to infinity. When n equals 1, plug in 1, we have c3 equals negative c1 over 2. When n equals 2, plug in 2, we have c4 equals negative c2 over 3. And c2 is negative c0, so we have c0 over 3. When n equals 3, plug in 3, we have c5 equals negative c3 over 4. And c3 is negative c1 over 2. So I have c1 over 8. Then our solution is equal to c0 plus c1 x plus c2 x squared plus that dot. What is c0? We don't know, just rewrite it. What is c1? We don't know, just rewrite it. What is c2? c2 is negative c0. What is c3? c3 is negative c1 over 2 x squared. What is x cubed? So c0, c1, c2, c3. And what is c4? c4 is c0 over 3 x to the 4th. Plus c1 over 8 x to the 5th plus dot dot dot. Now let's take a look at the c0 terms. And then factor it out. So in parentheses, we have 1 minus x squared plus 1 third x to the 4th plus dot dot dot. Now look for c1 terms. So we have x minus 1 half x cubed plus 1 8 x to the 5th plus dot dot dot. So this is our final solution. But we are given the initial value problem. So we have to solve for the constant here. C1 and C0, C0 and C1. So y of 0 equals, plug in 0 for x, we have C0 times 1 minus, so the rest of the power, the rest of this is just 0, plus C1 times, so this will be 0. And y of 0 equals 3. So we have C0 equals 3. So our y, our solution is equal to 3 times 1 minus x squared plus 1 third x to the fourth plus dot 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 plus c1 x minus 1 half x cubed plus 1 eighth x to the fifth plus dot dot dot. Take the first derivative of this one, give us this. So I believe that you know how to take the root derivative of simple polynomial. And for this one, derivative of x is 1, derivative of this one is 3 half square, derivative of this is 5 8 x to the 4th dot dot dot, and y prime of 0. So plug in 0 for x, so we have 0, 0, so everything, so the rest of this is just 0, plus c1, 1 minus, so the rest of this will be 0, and y prime of 0 is equal to negative 2, so this equal to negative 2. Oops. Then we have c1 equals negative 2. Alright, so eventually our final solution is equal to, so you want to replace c0 and c1 by 3 and negative 2 into this one. So we have y equals 3 times 1 minus x squared plus 1 third x to the 4th dot 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 plus c1, and c1 is negative 2 times x minus 1 half x cubed plus 1 8 x to the 5th dot dot dot. Alright, so this is your final solution of the initial value problem, so you don't have c constant being known. So that's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.